Hi everybody, happy new year, first of January 2022. As I plan to do this year, every first of the month I'm going to address the group, having announced on Facebook that I'm going sabbatical. I sign off. I'm going to try that the entire year, not being cluttered by, I guess, the ups and downs of so much sharing. So I will only be addressing the group, obviously I'm my American line dancing group, via the YouTube channel, which this is going to be the first of several releases that we will do for the year. What's new this year? We'll start the winter series. The winter series begins on Monday. The entire 2022 season I declared, or at least I announced to the group, as a farewell seasons. I'm talking about multiple seasons, right? Winter, spring, summer, fall. It depends, right? It could be sooner or the entire year. The reason why I call that farewell, let me just turn off our background music. You were actually listening to For Amarte Así, which is one of our featured selection from fall that will carry over to winter as part of our cool down, but we'll talk about that more later. I call it farewell because kind of giving the group a 1 year notice so that I can work on other projects, not totally out of the music and rhythm kind of umbrella that I've been passionate about, but something that I need to work on, and the timetable there is at least begin getting into the structure this year, moving into 2023, and that's when I probably will go sabbatical this time on the line dancing part of what I'm doing, so I can focus on that one. So that's like, I always do the forward planning way in advance. The good news is my assistant Caroline Kennedy has vocalized that rather than, I guess, taking over and putting a new structure, she will just continue the LDVALI, which stands for Line Dancing by My Name, Valentino Allen L. Isidro. So she'll continue the structure, and so that will be making for an easy transition, meaning throughout the year. Hopefully, she and I will find somebody else to assist her, per se, down the line. Because by now you know that basically we dance 7 days a week. And we have multiple cities that we are, at least I'm in contract with, not to mention the senior facilities that we do our music and motion program, which, by the way, will continue, okay? That's the main basis for my next project. Is the long and short of it is when I announce that somebody has to tell their stories. The people we meet in these various retirement communities have stories to tell. And Caroline and I are the only living proof of what they have told us, or at least what they experienced doing the music and motion with them. So I said somebody needs to put it down in writing before they get lost in the world of dementia. A friend of mine suggested that I should start the first chapter, and from then on at least other people can probably jump on the concept or the project, which right now is more along the line of the basic concept is journey in this world through music and rhythm, because that's how everything got discovered, or at least evolved. But that's another story. Okay? I'm here to present to you the winter series. So we have, at least during this pandemic time, when we began our outdoor line dancing in April of 2020, we have at least proven that it can be done safely. It doesn't matter if we're all restricted, safely distanced, at the time mask. Now we even have vaccination in our extra protection shield. Most of us, or at least all of us in our line dancing circle, is already has the booster shot. So we have three. So now that we are in an Omicron surge environment, I suspect we'll have to go back to, again, outdoor, or continue doing our mask dance gathering. So that's a given. In the past almost 2 years now on the pandemic, we've done actually more than 300 dances, 323 to be exact on my posting. We have, or at least I have proven to the group, that if you're doing it regularly, our senior muscles, memory muscles that we call, can still develop, and we keep it and we're able to do it. Some of them we need to revisit because we only do it once in a while, so that's why some are coming back. What I have done to plan for 2022 is ask the core group. The core group I refer to them because they're the ones who stuck with me doing 7 showcases during the year. Would you believe 7? We only planned for 1 and then all of a sudden it kept going. And then of course the demo session that we do in class. So I call them the core team. I ask them for their top 10. Some have a crossover. So now for the first batch for this year, we came up with at least 96 is what I posted, okay? Obviously, we cannot do that in one shot. Beginning next, this week, for week 1 of Winter Series, I put there on the outline 22. There's 22 dances already in there. So, month to month, that will change. Let's say by February, I may have to adapt, or add something, replace something, based on this list. Based on the skill level of those who will register in class. I have no control over that, so we have to modify that at some point. I also clarify that some of their requests fall under the all-time favorite of classics. That one falls into my concept of this year, the outdoor workshop that I do for San Mateo will all be focused on those dances, like Dizzy, Pontoon is a classic, or at least new classic, Chill Factor, anything that's kind of all-time favorite in the line dancing world, that will fall into the outdoor workshop. I'm hoping that people will sign up so that that's where they will learn that. Take the case of Dizzy, for example. I learned that one of the first hard dances I called, that I classified from my mentor, rest in peace, Jim McDonald, in 2006, before I took over. If you do something almost regularly, then it sticks with you. It's a dance that I somehow don't forget. It's almost like normal, I just do it like that. So now it's stuck with me from 2006 to now, right? I can do that just in my sleep. So the same concept, that if you do something regularly and if you like it, it will stay with you. That's the concept of why we bring some dancers back based on their request or their favorites. Not my favorite, I show it to them. If they're having fun, it becomes also their favorites. Also, we have proven that in our social dance mixer that we did 4 actually in 2021. So by the time we do the 5th one on January 9th, which is what I call the official start of our winter series, or at least the season. If you stick to the same playlist, almost like 80 to 90%, then the people who go attend regularly will develop memory muscle and remember those dances. So that's why I kept those playlists almost the same, with the help, of course, of a friend and one of our students, Lito, who is actually the one helping me promote the concept of mixed or shared dance floor with his partner, swing dancers. Keeping it the same playlist month to month will be part of their system. So I expect that the entire 2021, if you keep the same playlist 80 to 90%, by year end, it's almost like everything is just normal or typical, easy piece of cake. This year, I'm gonna convert now the Foster City showcase that we do at the end of the month, the last Sunday, and make it now the outdoor social dance. So meaning after some Bruno Senior Center social dance every second Sunday of the month, anything that we miss or not play there will be replayed at the outdoor social dance in Foster City. This year, kind of until further notice, no more showcase for now. But make that into an outdoor social party. And then anything left over, we just go back to what was played. Again, developing more memory muscle. So those are the changes that I'm doing for this year. And so I hope you don't mind that I always try to do something different. And that's why I'm addressing this. That is actually my sensor for the new doorbell. Sorry about that. After this, when I sign up, oh look, even my phone is making sound. All of this technicality. What can you do? So many gadgets. Maybe that's something that I need to go sabbatical to, but no, I need this for my dancing. So as I said, you will hear from me. I'm not going to totally get out of the social media, but I'm going to keep my YouTube channel. I'm just kind of scaling it down. I have other projects also for home that I need to do for my wife. So I promise I have to finish that. So that's something that I need to do also. So both personal and home project will have to be given priority in 2022. But at the same time, I live up to my commitment to my groupies that we call, okay? And then of course for new and returning students. So after this, when I sign off, my next session is, I am gonna do a how-to and a quick demo of the three new dances starting this week. I'm gonna tell it to you now. Race Like That is by Darren Bailey, one of our circuit pro idols that we follow. The other one is something I picked up from the World Network. This is a beginner dance. Life is a dance floor, easy to follow. And then my own new creation, Flame. That would be first, last, and my everything. It's an old 70s song that I'm bringing back because a friend, long-time friend, has mentioned that this is their, I guess, love song. And so this is actually for them that I submitted to Ticket. So that would be the three new dances I'm going to do some how-to after this. Happy New Year, stay safe, and see you in class
or at an event. This is Alan, Isidro Line Dance Maestro, signing off for now.